Good evening everyone. In the last lecture we have discussed the torque equation of induction motor. In this lecture we will discuss the condition for maximum torque. So in last lecture we have derived this torque equation. T is equals to Ks E2 square R2 divided by R2 square plus Sx2 square. So in this equation, as we know that stator input voltage, that is E1, is a constant. Supply voltage E1 is constant. And there is a fixed relation between E1 and E2. That is E1 by E2 is constant. Hence E2 is also constant. Again we know that R2 is constant. X2 is also constant. So if you observe this equation, E2, R2 and X2, these three quantities are constant. So, torque is directly proportional to slip, or slip is the only parameter which responsible to control a torque. Hence, to find out the maximum condition for torque, we have to derive, or we have to take a derivative of torque with respect to slip. That is dt by ds is equals to 0. So, put here the value of t. The T is Ks E2 square R2 whole divided by R2 square plus Sx2 bracket square. So this is a U by V. So we have to apply U by V rule of derivative. So this is a U. Write down U as it is. Then derivative of V minus V into derivative of U whole divided by U V square, which is equals to 0. So this whole term over here, it will go there and it will become 0. Now this term will remain as it is. Derivative of R2 square plus Sx2 bracket square will be 2 Sx2. This term will going to be 0. Then minus this term will as it is, and derivative of this is 2 S E2 R2 into K. So in the next step we'll get this. Okay. So now multiply this two brackets. So we will get 2S square into K X2 square E2 square R2 minus. Now multiply these two brackets also. This bracket with the R2 first, and then this bracket with the S2 square and X2 square. So we will get here R2 square into K E2 square R2 minus S2 S square K X2 square E2 square R2, which is equals to 0. This plus sign will become a minus while opening this bracket. Because of this minus sign, this here plus sign will become a minus over here. Then if you observe this, this whole term is as it is over here. So, this will become like this. Now, this whole term will be get subtracted by this term. Then we will get Ks square E2 square R2 into X2 square minus this term as it is, which is equals to 0. Now which thing will cancel? R2 now this R2 will cancel, then K will cancel. So in the next step we'll get Sx2 square minus R2 square is equals to 0. So from here Sx2 is equals to R2 and S square is equals to R2 square upon X2 square. So S is equals to R2 by X2. So this is the value of slip for which we will get the maximum torque. When the value of slip S is equals to R2 by X2, that time you will get the maximum torque of your motor. This is the slip at which torque is maximum and it is denoted by Sm. It is the ratio of rotor resistance and reactance at standstill. This is the condition for maximum torque. Now we will find out the value of maximum torque, magnitude of maximum torque. Now substitute Sm is equals to R2 by X2 in the torque equation and denote that torque by Tm. So Tm is equals to K Sm E2 square R2 whole divided by R2 square plus Sm X2 whole bracket square. Now put the value of Sm, that is R2 by X2. So you will get the equation like this. Then this whole downward term will get cancelled out and you will get K E2 square upon 2 X2 Newton meter. If you solve this equation, you will get this. So this is the value of maximum torque you will get when you will put S is equals to Sm, that is R2 by X2. Then we will see some torque ratios. The first is full load and maximum torque ratio. Now to find out full load torque, suppose Sf is the full load slip. Now replace S by Sf in torque equation. So you will get TfL is equals to K Sf E2 square R2 whole divided by R2 square plus Sf X2 whole bracket square. Then similarly, while finding out maximum torque, put in place of slip, put Sm. So you will get this equation. Now divide TfL by Tm. So divide this equation by this equation. Now if you observe this equation, this K E2 square R2, K E2 square R2, this term will cancel. So here only remain Sf upon Sm. So write down this Sf upon Sm into this side and R2 square plus Sm X2 whole bracket square divide by this R2 square plus Sf X2 whole bracket square on this side. Like this. Okay. So you will get this. Now take X2 square common from this term. So here you will get R2 by X2 whole bracket square plus here will remain Sm square only. Then here also we have taken X square, X2 square common. So here again you will get R2 by X2 whole bracket square plus Sf square. Now what is this R2 by X2? It is Sm. So it will be Sm square. Here also it will be Sm square. So you will get equation something like this. So it will be 2 Sm square whole divided by Sm upon Sm square plus Sf. So now this Sm and this Sm square will cancel. So you will get 2 Sf Sm whole divided by Sm square plus Sf square, like this. Okay. So this is the torque ratio, full load torque upon maximum torque. You have full load slip, maximum slip, then you can find out this ratio. Okay, so easily. Now next is a starting torque and maximum torque. Now we have, in the last lecture we have derived the formula for starting torque. So from there you can put the value of TST and maximum torque, and by solving it similarly you can find, you will get this formula. This formula is equals to 2Sm upon 1 plus Sm square. So if you have the value of maximum slip Sm, you will get this TST upon Tm. Thank you.